I've returned to our HVAC database here in PiSystem Explorer, and recall that we've gone in and we've created all three zones with their corresponding equipment, and then we used our PiBuilder tool to go in and en masse configure all the PiPoint data references for these various elements so that they're using the tags with the correct code corresponding to the zone and equipment that we're looking at. Now, I also mentioned that it would be an improvement if we could use substitution parameters for the equipment elements like we did for the zone elements. And so we'll need to go in and make some alterations to the equipment template. If you remember from our zone template, we were getting these tag names using a substitution parameter that plugs in our zone number from the attribute value of the zone number. And we'd like to do the same thing for our equipment. Here we're just been specifying tag names and editing each element through the PiBuilder to plug in the correct tag name. So here, not only do I want this to be a review of what we discussed previously with the zones and substitution parameters, but I'm going to extend it to show how we can move around the hierarchy to get information from elements other than the element that owns the actual attribute. And then I want to extend this further to show how one of the really powerful uses of AF is to have AF build tags for you. So in that case, whenever you build a new element off of a template, you can have AF go build the tag for you on the data archive. So let's go ahead and see how that's done. Let's start with one of our PiPoint data references in the equipment template. So we'll start with power here. And what we want to do is we have the first two digits of this three-digit number here. We just hard-coded that. The first digit, remember, is the zone number. The second is the equipment code. So we want to have appropriate substitution parameters for these two numbers so that the PiPoint data references for the elements will be filled in automatically using the substitution parameters. So let's start with the second digit first, getting the equipment code. Now that one we have an attribute for in our equipment elements. So this will be the same kind of syntax that we used when we set up our zone element template. So this similar syntax, percent at, then the attribute name, and a closing percent sign. So going back to power, go ahead and delete that second one. And we're going to do percent at, because we want an attribute value. Attribute name is equipment code. And that's how we're going to get the equipment code filled in now. Next one we want is the zone number. So here's where we need to learn something new. If we jump back to our elements, and we look at our hierarchy. First of all, our equipment elements don't have an attribute called zone number, but just above them at the parent level for zone, we do have a zone number attribute. So what we need to do is figure out a substitution parameter that allows us to go from the equipment element level up to the parent element level, which is the zone level, and then pull out this attribute value of zone number. And I'll go ahead and type in the syntax for that and then give some explanation. So it's going to be percent at dot dot backslash pipe, then the attribute name, which is zone number, and then the closing percentage sign. So you can see that it's essentially the same as what we did before, except that we've added this dot dot backslash, and then the pipe is just to indicate that we want an attribute that's owned by an element. So you might be wondering why we have the dot dot backslash to get us up to the parent level element. Well, for those of you that are familiar with using the command prompt to navigate around a Windows file structure, this should look very familiar to you. So let me get to a directory that I'm very familiar with. I'll use the PiHome environmental variable. It'll take us to our 32-bit PiPC folder. Let's say I want to go up a level to the parent folder, which is the program files x86 folder. Well, I would do a cd for change directory and then dot dot backslash, and you'll see that that takes me up a level. So that dot dot backslash is the same type of syntax we're using in AF, where we use that with our substitution parameter to telef that we want to go up one level to the parent element level. Likewise, if we were in an element that had a child element, and we wanted to get an attribute value out of that child element, we could do something similar to what we do in the command prompt. Here, if I want to get to a lower level, I can do cd dot, single dot, and then a slash, and then the folder name, which is pypc. And you'll see that takes me down a level to the folder I specified. So for AF substitution parameters, you would do something like percent at dot backslash, then the child element name, then the pipe, and then the attribute inside of that child element that you want, and then the percent sign to close it out. Now you're not restricted to going down or up one level. You can go multiple levels by stringing these dot slash combinations together. So for example, if I wanted to go down a couple levels, I can do cd dot slash, and I know there's a help folder in here, and then another slash, and I know that there's a en folder within the help folder. So I can do that to get down two levels, and you could do the same if you had a child element and then a grandchild element. And so you want to go up multiple levels, and command prompt I'd do cd dot dot backslash dot dot backslash, and you see that takes me back up two levels to the pypc folder. Similarly, if we wanted to get a grandparent element, let's say we want the grandparent element name, we could do percent dot dot backslash dot dot backslash element percent, and that's going to get us the name of the grandparent element. And the final thing I want to show you is that we can also get to the root level element the same way that we get to a root level directory. So in the command prompt, if I want to go to the root level, I can just do cd and then a backslash, and you see that takes me to the root level, the C directory. So similarly in AF, in a little bit we're going to add a facility level element that is the parent of all the zone elements. So then if we were down here in one of our equipment level elements and we wanted to get a substitution parameter from the root element, which would be that new facility element, then we could just do something like percent backslash element percent, and that's going to get us the name of the root element. If I want an attribute out of that element, then I can just do at backslash pipe, and then the attribute name. So that's just a brief tutorial on some more advanced features of using substitution parameters. And if you need further details, I'd encourage you to look at the PySystem Explorer user guide, where there's a lot of good examples and a lot of good explanations on substitution parameter syntax. So let me close out of my command prompt here. And then I'll get back to the library and back to this power attribute template. And so we have our two substitution parameters in here now. I'll go ahead and check that in. And then we'll go back to our elements, and I'll go to the blower for zone 1, and let's just go ahead and revert the power here to the template. So now it's going to be using the substitution parameters. If I just want to prove that to myself quickly, I can go in here and mess up my nice configuration string. I'll just add a lowercase a to the end of the tag name, check that in. If I go back here, now you see that my power is not resolving correctly because of that lowercase a on the end of the name. So that proves to me that it's actually using the configuration string in the template. And I'll just fix that before we proceed. Check that in. And now we can see everything's working fine with our power attribute.